Minister of Industries, Mr. Industry. Mr.
It gives me great pleasure to welcome His Excellency Mr. Hideaki, relationship with India. Indians have traditionally had great love, admiration, and have reached a new height with the assumption of office by our new Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, who as Chief Minister visited Japan several times and struck up a good rapport with Japanese leaders, in particular with the present Prime Minister, His Excellency Mr. Shinzo Abe. When in Japan in April this year, we learnt of the popularity of Mr. Omura, who has been elected to the House of Representatives for 5 consecutive terms, has served in the Central Cabinet, was elected as Governor in 2011 with the second largest number of votes in Aichi Prefecture's history.
And
our Chief Minister's career mirrors that of Mr. Omura's. She is a 5-time Member of Parliament, 4 times Member of the State Legislature, a former Central Minister, and 2 times Chief Minister. In her current term, she has led her party to a landslide victory. We recognize that Aichi Prefecture is the growth engine of Japan. It ranks number 1 for over 37 years in manufacturing. Its GDP is higher than that of several countries, including Denmark, Thailand, etc. It is home to Toyota, the world's largest automobile manufacturer, to Denso, the world's largest component manufacturer, and many other iconic companies. We will have opening remarks by our 2 leaders. We will then have a presentation which will take stock of developments which have taken place since our Chief Minister's visit to Japan in April this year. At the end, our Industries Minister put some of the deliberations and suggest a way forward. I now invite our Chief Minister to make her opening remarks. Thank you.
And welcome to Rajasthan. The warmest of welcomes to His Excellency Mr. Omura, the governor of the Aichi Prefecture. I'm really thankful to the Embassy of Japan, who I had the pleasure of meeting this time when I was in April in your very beautiful country. And the first sight was something that I will never forget. And to visit Japan, then the monsoons are when Rajasthan is at its greenest, because in this desert state, the monsoons, when they come, and they've come well this year, it's a very, very pleasant and beautiful sight. So despite your exhaustion, I do hope that you've enjoyed whatever little you have got to see. Our visit to Japan and then to your prefecture was extremely fruitful, very rewarding, and certainly very enjoyable. Japanese Prime Minister, Mr. Abe, who mentioned that the Japanese government and investors have been watching very closely the improvement in the investment climate in Rajasthan. I had the honor and privilege of meeting the Minister of Economy, Trade and Industry, Meti, Mr. Miyazawa, and also the senior functionaries of JETRO, JICA and JBIC. Outcome of the visit, the Rajasthan government is collaborating with Japanese firms for sharing technology, especially for infrastructure, urban development, industrial and technological development. I have said this at many forums and I will repeat this here. Japan does and will continue to hold a very, very special place as one of our closest and one of our most reliable international partners. We have managed to, over the years, build a strong and enduring relationship, and we are willing and ready to find ever more new ways to deepen this engagement. The turning point for us was in July 2006, when RICO signed an MOU with JETRO to promote jointly the first exclusive Japanese investment zone at Neem Rana. This is promoted on 1,167 acres of land on the majority are in auto manufacturing, and they have been allotted 473 acres of land, and 38 units have started commercial operations. So Neem Rana, which was once a very, very small and sleepy town, and this is just about 70 kilometers from New Delhi, has now transformed into a throbbing industrial hub with a huge manufacturing plants and warehouses. So Daikin, Nissan, Nippon, Mitsui, Mikoni and others, Honda, the first car plant of Rajasthan, is also based out of Neem Rana. Now this has acted as a trigger to development of auto ancillary sectors in this region. And over the last 10 years, whoever was in government, the engagement with government, Japanese companies, remained strong and continuous. This is the hallmark of policy paradigm in our state. So we signed 6 MOUs during my Japan visit. Packages for Daikin and Yazaki have been approved. Hira is in the process of setting up the skill development center at Neem Rana in association with Hirohama India Private Limited on a leased accommodation. Extensively acting, we're interacting with Japanese small industry units in India, Japan and Thailand for investment in the plug and play facilities which are being proposed by HIP in Neemrana. So we have a long term plan. In order to create and secure a better future for Rajasthan and create a more prosperous economy, we would like to continue to work with Japan to achieve these goals. Companies of the Aichi Prefecture have made investment of around $85 million already in Rajasthan, in the Japanese zone. Your strengths, electronics, ceramics, and auto components are what we are very, very interested in. Through an early and very meaningful tie-up between business houses from Aichi Prefecture with Indian counterparts and the resultant investment taking place here in Rajasthan. So with stable and popular governments, both in the center and in Rajasthan, we are confident of making Make in India a global buzzword. And we look forward to making you our most important partner today to consider our offerings and to pursue your business and investment interests with us. This opportunity arises also at the Resurgent Rajasthan Partnership Summit on the 19th and 20th of November 2015 in Jaipur, which is being organized by the government of Rajasthan. So we offer a competitive business environment, developed infrastructure, a very remarkable talent pool, geographical advantages that ensure an ideal environment for investment. So we recognize the importance of the Aichi Prefecture, and I would again reiterate that we would like very much to work with you. At the same time, I have extended an invitation to the Japanese Prime Minister, Mr. Abe, to consider your country's participating as our partner country at the Rajasthan, Resurgent Rajasthan event. So again, on behalf of the government of Rajasthan, I welcome you all to our state, and I hope that your visit here and your interactions will be productive and very fruitful. We're open to many new ideas, creativity and initiatives. We would like to put this to work in building a stronger and resurgent Rajasthan, and I look forward to welcoming you all, Your Excellency, in the West. Thank you.
Once again, within this year, after meeting in April in Nagoya,
I would like to make use of this opportunity to thank you personally for arranging this wonderful gathering with your senior people here. And I would also like to the prefecture. There are people like Mr. Kumuichi, the chairperson.
昨日、伊佐口実、茂木市長にもお会いをいたしまして、日本とインドのですね、経済交流、経済関係をと、進めていこうということで、合意をいたしました。私から、愛知はですね、日本の製造業のですね、中心でありまして、製造業の生産額は、4000億ドルを超えております。で、合わせて、インドに進出している日系日本の製造業の1割を超える企業が愛知からの企業であります。
India from Japan, and when we look at it from Aichi Prefecture, it is about 10% of the total companies.
そういう我々がですね、愛知県としてインドのメイクインインディア同胞プログラム施策は応援できるということを申し上げました。そういう中でラジャスタン州はラジャス州のリーダーシップのもとでメイクインインディア政策をですね、まさにリーダーとしてこうしたインフラ整備、そして日本の企業の、まあ、ニューアル工業団地をはじめ、そして投資環境の、またラジャスタン州は日本とインドで ですね、合流したデリー・ムンバイ間のですね、デリー・ムンバイコリドーですね、のまさにその中心間としてですね、大変これからもインフラ整備が進み、発展をされると期待をいたしております。また新村の工業団地がほぼいっぱいになった次はギロット工業団地ですか、をまた整備をされると気をしておりまして、また多くの日本の企業が進出するのではないかというふうに期待をいたしております。また今後ともですね、我々愛知県と、まあ、愛知、そして中日本の中部地域ですね、中部地域とまたラジャスタン州の皆さんとの、交流を深めですね、さらにお互いが発展をしていくウィンウィンの関係が作れればと思っております。まあ今回の訪問で一昨日モディ首相と私これで3回目の、ミーティングを、できましたけれども、もう ラジェ首相とはこの3ヶ月で2回ということですね。また友好関係が深めていけるんじゃないかと期待を出しております。またぜひですね、近いうち3回目の3回目ミーティングをね、ラジェ首相として、ね、できればと。
And I do look for
歓迎、心から感謝申し上げて、また今後とも我々愛知中部地域とラジャスタン州との友好関係が発展することを、期待いたしまして、私からの、ご挨拶とさせていただきます。
はい、
Thank you。
Rajasthan is a land of opportunities and it is strategically located between the political capital and the band of 150 km land on both sides of
で、インド政府と貨物専用船の両側150キロずつ取った幅のところとなります。
As infrastructure is the backbone for economic development, Rajasthan has got 328 industrial areas which includes SEZs and specialized parks like IT parks.
28の工具団地がございまして、その中には経済的特区もあるパークストーパーなど。
The state is self-sufficient. The Japanese
was
conceptualized. As the Chief Minister already signed the MOU to develop Japanese zone in Nepal.
Your Excellency or any other members of the delegation would like to raise
I just got introduced. I'm Goroku.
私初めてインドに参りました。今日
今日で5日目でありますけれども、本当にインドの皆さん方と好意的で、その温かくね、接していただいて、本当に感動いたしました。ですが、私も愛知県議会の代表としてですね、インドと日本がさらに経済、文化等々を通して交流を深めますように、の方が中国、日中、議員友好議員連盟というのを作っております。それともう一つ、日越、ベトナムでありますけれども、ベトナムとも友好議連というのを作っております。ということも友好議員連盟を作っていく予定をしております。これから私、日本へ帰りまして、仲間の皆さんと共に話をしながら、インドとも友好議員連盟ができるように、最大限の努力をしてまいりたいと思っています。はい。
Thank you very much. Information.
で、三田でございます。今日はラジェ首相をはじめ、政府の皆様でこうしてお会いし、またお話しする機会を与えてくださいまして、大変ありがとうございます。感謝しております。
Thank you very much. I'm Mita.
経済連合会といっても少しお分かりじゃないかと思います。若干私の仕事のご説明をします。中部圏、愛知県を含む5つの県のを我々の活動範囲としている経済団体であります。
It's an economic federation which focuses on the activities in this sector.
もちろんこの愛知県、最も私の経済団体の中では大きな影響力を持っている愛知県です。それからご存知の鈴木自動車がある静岡県、ホンダがある三重県、また静岡、長野という5つの県を活動範囲としています。で、約750の会社団体が加入しておりますけれども、今申し上げた大きな会社も我々の団体のメンバーとして活躍しております。エネルギー出荷額がおよそ、もうちょっと3年前の古いデータですが、9600億ドルぐらいです。で、これはほぼ日本の4分の1の生産額を有しております。この活動は経済の活性化、また地域の活性化のために何をしていくべきかということを提言しております。ご存知かもしれませんが、日本経団連というのはございますけれども、それと割と似た活動の内容で、それをこの中部地区で活動しています。詳細についてまたパンフレット持ってきました。後ほどご覧いただけると
思います。And I would like to leave some pamphlets here regarding our body, which gives more details about the activities which we carry.
このインドへ投資するときにいろんな課題があります。先ほども少しお話が出ておりますけれども、いわゆるインフラ、電力であるとか、水であるとか、道路であるとか、そういったインフラの整備が一部まだ不足している点が一つの大きな課題であるというふうに思います。ラジェスタン州では、投資するインセンティブを働かすということで、いろんな土地代を軽減するとかですね、手を打っていらっしゃるので、それは非常に我々にとってありがたいことだというふうには思っています。投資して、その仕事を始める前に非常に多くの手続きが必要である、複雑さであるとか、それから税が大変複雑な徴税制度があるとか、また労働問題であるとか、そういったことがさまざまな課題があります。ではそういった課題についても、デリーの政府をはじめ、各州、ラジャスタン州でもそういうことに対応しようというご努力をされていることを十分理解はしております。このところでそういう課題を、解決できる能力と人員、そういったものを持ってますけれども、やはり中堅中小企業が出てこようとすると、なかなかそれが課題となって出にくいというところがありますので、ぜひそういうところをですね、改善するようなシンプルなシステムにしていただくことが非常に重要ではないかなと
思います。
インドの経済の発展のためには、ホンダであるとか、トヨタであるとか、いわゆるアッセンブルの大きな会社だけではなくて、やはりその会社を支えていくサプライヤーですね、ティア1であるとか、ティア2であるとか、そういう中堅中小企業をしっかり育成していかないと、この国の大きな発展のために、発展のためにはそういうことがぜひ必要だと思っております。これからの発展に寄与するんではないかな、そんなふうに思います。
concern about the need to improve the business environment and to make the entry of new investors much easier. We have been making sustained efforts to try and improve and ease the business environment, and I would briefly like to highlight some of those measures. For small and medium investors, we have made amendments in the labor laws, in various acts like the Factories and Boilers Act, the Industrial Disputes Act, and several other acts, all with the objective of trying to make the environment for small and medium investors much more favorable. Likewise, we have also tried to liberalize the process for grant of environmental clearances, land-related approvals, and even tax simplification. In touch with JETRO, who have been espousing the cause of Japanese investors and bringing to our notice the difficulties that are being faced by Japanese companies from time to time. I would only like to, on behalf of the Chief Minister and on behalf of all my colleagues, I would like to assure you that we will not leave any stone unturned in addressing the problems that may be faced by Japanese companies in our state. In fact, JETRO, we keep meeting almost on a monthly basis. We are in dialogue with JETRO, and we have by and large removed almost all outstanding, we have resolved almost all outstanding issues. I'll now request our Industries Minister to deliver his concluding address.
It's a pride for us to have the Japanese zone in Neemrana, because any product that has a seal of Japan, it's a seal of quality. As Industries Minister, I still miss the opportunity of visiting your area, and I missed out on having some good Japanese food and sushi, which I believe is one, maybe, I mean, if not the best in India, at least the best in Rajasthan. As you all have realized, what I heard from hearing from you all, that your Japanese zone is located not only in the most preferred economic industrial zone of Rajasthan, but probably of India, where you all are located presently. In a couple of years, you will have the DMIC corridor, the trains operating, which are going to put the containers from New Delhi to the Mumbai port in 14 hours. Our government of India, our central government, has already given approvals for a new airport between Jaipur and Delhi, which is located very close to your industrial zone. That will be a great asset to the industrialization process in that area. Surveys are being carried out for a new alignment between New Delhi and Jaipur, a new highway, which will not only cut the distance, but it will be very fast movement of vehicles between Delhi and Jaipur. Close to what we call the National Capital Region, it's a very preferred area. And last but not the least, the catalyst to our development is our Honorable Chief Minister, who I can assure you, if not faster, she's as fast as your bullet trains, without any stops. Thank profusely Embassy of Japan, New Delhi, and JETRO for helping make this get-together successful. Special thanks to our Honorable Chief Secretary, Mr. Rajan, and his team, which comprises of Mrs. Veenu Gupta, our Principal Secretary Industries, Mr. Samit Sharma, and our entire bureaucracy for having worked hard to make this get-together successful. I hope you enjoyed your few hours of sightseeing pre-lunch, and I'm sure you will enjoy the Amir Fort and a nice elephant ride post-lunch. but it's, you know, you're, this is one of the worst months as far as the weather is concerned, because not only is it hot, it's humid also. We will grace our Resurgent Rajasthan, our mega event in from 19th to 21st November. The weather will be very nice, and I am sure you will keep a little extra time, because Rajasthan has a lot to offer, from the forests, tigers, from forts, palaces, lakes, mountains, jungles. So, you know, do give some time. The weather will also be nice. So we hope to see you during the Resurgent Rajasthan in November. And finally, the best part of our program is the lunch being hosted by our Honorable Chief Minister. You will enjoy a lovely cuisine with all our nice spices. Now, when I say spices, they can be very hot, they can be mild. We have ordered mild spices, but India has very healthy spices like turmeric, cumin seed, various forms of cardamoms, and famous for spices which are very healthy. And you will be dining in the Swarna Mahal, which was once, not many years back, the place where a lot of all the Maharajas of India dined, very famous, and the royal family was living in this palace, Rambagh Palace, not many years back. So I hope you have an enjoyable lunch, enjoy our Indian cuisine, and thank you very much once again for having come all the way. And we hope to strengthen our ties, remove any hurdles which may exist, as honorable members had pointed out, and we hope to do business together, and which will be mutually beneficial to your province and to the state of Rajasthan. Thank you once very much.
Where is the washroom? Yeah, no. You what? So I missed that. So this is central Japan. Very interesting for tourism. They have to talk about it. And then his other hat. That's also very, very important for us. Just look at the tourism part. Because we looked at the industry. But you know, tourism for us is also like an industry. The famous Fuji.
This is the area where
Toyama. Chubu Central.
Japan, Suri International Airport.
So when we came to Nagoya, we used the Shinkansen.
Yes.
Been watching this on television for so long.
What are they?
You haven't seen these. These have discovered the hot springs. So when it snows, these sit in the hot springs. And you know, the blissful look of
it. Actually, hot springs are there.
Now look at this. I don't think you can get there because they've taken it over.
Morning, we are in a business.
From the
case. Told that you're setting up a desk, IG desk. So what I was saying is that country to country happens in a day.
the states to states. They need to develop their own relationships. We're making an effort right now. Because the work has to get done here. This is the first time after this Prime Minister. States have been encouraged to go out because the spirit of cooperative federalism come, let me take with the famous story in the head.
Thank you.